Election season approaches. The Tippecanoe County Election Board is adopting new strategies during the pandemic. News 18's Marvin Bill spoke with the Election Board chairman about the impact that COVID-19 will have on election season.
This is new for the Election Board, the Indiana Election Division.
Tippecanoe County Election Board Chairman Randy Vonderheide says the board is preparing for an increase in absentee ballots this election season.
We expect a much higher than a normal volume. I mean, the estimation anywhere between 7,500 and 10,000 absentee ballots.
Vonderheide says to date, the board has already received more than 2,000 absentee ballot requests. That's compared to the 2016 election season, where only 500 requests were submitted.
We're going to need to start earlier and have many more people working just because of the scanning limitations for the scanning equipment.
That's why the board approved to start processing and counting absentee ballots at 6 a.m. on Election Day. They have also expanded their team on top of the several returning poll workers and allowing 16 and 17-year-olds to help by applying to be an election officer, something the board has offered every year.
I'm very pleased to report we are not having trouble. Regular poll workers that we've had for years, by and large, almost all of them, are indicating that they're going to work for the public again this year.
As far as voting locations, Vonderheide says that's a moving target. As of now, Payless and Purdue University are not on the current list of 14 voting locations.
Our March 9th meeting, we locked in our early voting and our vote centers. And after COVID-19, that has had to change.
Vonderheide goes on to say the Indiana Election Division also limited early voting to just 1 week instead of two.
We're also concerned as an election board about the safety of our poll workers. So we've made every effort to assure that safety.
In Tippecanoe County, Marvin Bills, News 18.
And Vonderheide says the Secretary of State is also working with the county to provide personal protective equipment for poll workers. He says people interested in absentee ballots should submit an application by midnight of May 19th. You can find more information on voting locations and a link to that application on this story at W.